So my husband Kyle and I are first-time home buyers, and we are actively working on a down payment to purchase our first home in San Diego. Yes, crazy, I know. And we recently went on a couple of home tours, and I had no idea what questions to ask. So I took it to social media, and with your help, we were able to come up with a ton of really great questions to ask a realtor during your first home tour, so stick around. Hey guys, it's Justine with Debt Free Millennials, the channel to help you crush your debt and live payment free. I think for a lot of millennials, getting into your home for the very first time is super exciting and one that we've delayed. This decision has been delayed for a lot of us due to debt, due to us going through a series of financial crises. Don't even get me started. However, there are a ton of us who are still working on this goal, making this a reality, and I wanted to cover some of the best questions that you can ask a realtor because when you're making this type of purchase, it's a big deal to understand and know the cost that goes into home ownership because it's not just the mortgage payment. It's not just the HOA or the taxes. There's so much more that goes into a property and maintaining it correctly. So I ended up taking this to Instagram and asking people for help on what I should ask when I was thinking about touring a home here in San Diego. So I actually had separated this out into five different categories. First is about the seller, next is about the house. Then you'll want to ask some questions about the neighborhood, utilities, and then I have a whole section on outdoor. So I think it's really important that you ask questions about the seller because you want to understand exactly why are they moving? How long have they lived here? Will the sellers include a home warranty? What's included? Keep in mind that when I talked to a realtor, they said everything was negotiable. So those are some things that you can kind of play with as you're asking these questions on your own home tour. In addition to understanding what the property tax rate is and what type of closing costs the seller is going to cover, you'll want to know, are there already offers on this listing yet, and how likely are those offers to be accepted? If you have an idea if there's already offers on the table, then that may sway your decision on whether or not you want to put in a higher offer or just walk away altogether. Next is about the house, and this one I found super important and helpful. A lot of people said you need to ask, how old is the roof? Is it roof or roof? Roof. I don't know. But how old is it? And then are the kitchen appliances included? Is the washer and dryer included? Does the garage have a garage opener? I know that's silly to ask, but really, what if there isn't? And then you're stuck with a garage door that you can't even open from the outside. My dad also had a really good question of where the breaker panel is located and how old is it? Your electrical system is really important, including plumbing as well. You'll want to understand how old the plumbing is and what type of maintenance is on record for the house within the last 5, 6 years. Then you'll also want to ask about things like when the home was last treated for pests. Then you'll also want to know if the home is in a flood zone area or if it's next to the elements. Is it close in a location where hurricane season is a real thing? How does that affect insurance premiums? And then for the neighborhood, you'll want to know, what are the comps? What do the comps look like in this area? Is a house in a flood zone? We talked about that. And then are there developmental projects in the area? Take a look around the neighborhood and see what type of growth opportunities are available. That's always a really good sign. Is there an HOA, and then how much? And then is there a Mela Ruz, which is specific to California? That's a specific tax. And then utilities. How much is the monthly water bill, the electricity bill? Is there a gas bill? what's trash look like? All of those things can factor into the monthly cost of owning that home. Then you'll want to know if your hot water heater is gas or electric. How old is it? When was the last time it received any maintenance? And same thing with your AC and heater. How old is it? When was the last time it was serviced? And then lastly, you'll want to take a look at the outside of the home, the backyard. Is there a pool or a hot tub that you need to service and factor in those costs? Is there an irrigation system that's already set up for plants? Is it manual or automatic? Where is the water hose? All of those types of things factor into your outdoor area. So I've actually put all of these questions into one PDF that you can download for free. I will link to that below. And I'm using this as a checklist when I go on my next home tour so that I can say, okay, I've asked all of these questions and I'm not forgetting anything. I think it's really important that you could print out the PDF so that you can take it with you and make notes as you go. So if you're interested in that, I will link to that in the description box below for you to pick up for free. Be sure to check out my whole home buying series. I have a complete playlist as Kyle and I navigate home ownership for the very first time in San Diego. I think it's a really fun way to see how we're doing this and all the things that go into buying your first home. So be sure to check out that playlist. I will link to that in the description box below, and I'll catch you in another video.